guys. Are you afraid of the camera? Stand out there where we can see the whole thing.
Oh, you jumped over my shell, eh?
Wow.
Is your dress okay, Joe?
Yeah.
Looks nice. You aren't going to be embarrassed to take her out and have all those other boys see those pretty shoulders, are you? Okay. Joe's got his shiny shoes. I mean, those things are nothing, but how'd you get those so shiny?
Spit.
Spit on them?
Spit.
Let's do some dancing.
So what's going to be the best part of the night, Joe? Did you have any dinner yet?
Not
yet. So you're gonna go eat first, right?
Good.
You're gonna go eat, and then what are you gonna do, Janette?
Dance.
Over where are you gonna dance?
The same place we're gonna eat.
Where's that?
River Station.
Oh, that's in Peoria. River Station. That's an old abandoned railroad station that they turned into a dining room right down by the river, isn't it? You gonna watch the river while you eat?
I don't know, I'll probably be staring at my food.
Is that, if I was you, I wouldn't be staring at my food. And not with a pretty girl like that, gee. I mean, I'd be looking at her all the time. You look pretty good. Where'd you get that makeup job?
Whoa!
You did it yourself? Yeah, it looks great. Man, look at those eyes. This ought to turn out fantastic. Pretty colors. Oh, that's a nice necklace, too. Your mom made that dress with you, huh?
Yes.
How many days does it take to make that dress?
How many days?
Three days and $20?
Maybe. Well, that's
70?
No.
Okay. Oh, look who's sitting over here watching all of this. It's Debbie Ann and Clint. What's Clint doing? Oh, he's playing his little game.
Tight
now? No. Yes. Oh, that's a pretty nice corsage. Did you make that yourself, Joe?
Yes.
How long did it take to do that?
About 5 minutes.
5 minutes? Janette, did you make his?
Yeah.
How long did it take you to make that one? 20 minutes? Joe, you better do something. Work a little longer here. She's ahead of you. Well, let's see. What else you got? You got that super necklace on. Where'd you get that necklace?
I don't know. Where'd I get it,
Dad? Oh, can't imagine.
I got it for Christmas from St. Paul's.
What you got on your other hand there, Janette?
Nothing.
Nothing. Where'd that little ring go that you used to wear?
It's upstairs. I'm not done yet.
Oh, you gotta go get it on, huh?
Yes, I'm gonna get it on.
Okay. Well, we'll turn this off. Wait till you get back. We gotta see this special friendship ring here.
Give me some, please. You need them. We had a new toy. I kind of like this. You can walk anywhere. Good evening and welcome to our spring concert. One of these days we're going to get the date right and it's going to be nice and comfortable in here for all of you. You're not going to have to worry about fanning and seeing how many layers you can keep off, you know. We have a wonderful, excellent program, a combination of all three arts that are offered here in VA. We have instrumental, vocal, and artistic. And we're going to honor some very special people tonight. But at first, before we even begin, if I could have all the seniors that are graduating this year, if we could just honor them right now before we even begin the concert. Would they stand, please? Seniors, graduating seniors. Beginning our concert will be the instrumental section under the direction of Miss Jean West. Mrs. Jean West, I'm sorry. Oh, sorry. Okay, it's my old age of popping up, you know. Oh, so she has been here as interim band director since Mrs. Larson's been on maternity leave. And I think she's enjoyed her stay here. I think we've, you know, she kind of likes us. So, under the direction of Mrs. Jean West, the band will be performing first. So without further delay, the band.
Bear with us for a brief moment while we retune.
Thank you. letter here to read to you from Mrs. Larson couldn't make it here tonight. Says, dear ladies and gentlemen, although I am unable to attend this evening's performance, which, by the way, I'm sure is sounding wonderful, I did not want to miss the opportunity to speak about this year's John Villasusa Award recipient. This award, the highest band award available, is bestowed upon one deserving senior band member each year. This year's recipient has been a loyal school band member for 4 years. When I began teaching here just 3 short years ago, she was a member of my original high school band, or should I say ensemble, which consisted of 2 flute players, 2 trumpet players, and a drummer, which you can tell in drum. At a time when many others gave up on DNAC band program, she stuck it out, always believing that things could and would get better. In order to continue to participate in band, she survived numerous schedule changes and the dreaded 0-hour PE. I can always count on her flexibility in rehearsal, playing whatever percussion instrument I happen to need, never questioning or complaining. She's taken younger students under her wing and helped them to become better musicians. In addition, her knowledge of music theory should be commended. It has been my privilege to work with this young lady during the past 3 years and mine for the past semester. I've enjoyed watching her grow and mature as both a person and a musician. Therefore, it is with great pleasure that I announce Erica Green, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Dick Green, as this year's recipient of the John Villasusa Band Award. Like,
thank you. I know that I'm an avid songwriter, so I wrote this one last year. It's called Forever. Well, I've been to your eyes and saw the future. I held your hand and felt the faith. I kissed your lips and tasted forever. Forever is supposed to last forever. Is there a limit on how long forever lasts? Can we go on through life still thinking it's forever? Time does fly, and you're having fun. But after forever, I never thought I'd be here. Crying cause
Oh, Lisa did a good job, but wow, in the last 3 years, she's improved significantly and always comes out with the cleverest ideas, and it's always fun to look at her artwork. This year, it goes to Dana Davies. This is always a fun one to give because usually the student is as original as their artwork. And this one goes without question. Damon Walcott makes me smile all the time. The next award goes to Best of Show. And if you've walked around the room already, you've seen that it goes to Andy Allman this year for the third time. He's kind of sweeping the Best of Show. We're going to get rid of him this year, so other people have a chance. Okay, don't go. Don't go. Okay. Next award is for the Art Student of the Year. And it goes, of course, to Andy, since I asked him to stay here. I want to brag a little bit about Andy's work. It's in the corner, and for 4 years, wow, that's about all I can say. Not only is he talented, but he's original, and the sky's the limit for him. He's gotten a nice scholarship in art, and is he Gilligan? Or haven't decided yet? Haven't decided yet. Art Institute, too. There's a couple other places that are trying to get a hold of him, but I don't blame them. He also, at this point, has several pieces of artwork that are traveling around the state and around the nation, too. He won first place in the PTA contest reflections, thank you. And he did win for the high school for the state of Illinois, and he represented the state of Illinois in Washington, D.C., where he received an honorable mention. That's pretty good. So we'd like to congratulate him and good luck.
Thank you. Everybody head to the gym.
Outstanding Teacher Award. Several months later, Mr. Gallion died of cancer,
and subsequently the coveted honor was known as the Galleon Award. The Galleon Award is presented to the full-time instructor who is voted as outstanding by students at Illinois Central College. Professor Tony Ali becomes the first professor in the history of Illinois Central College to receive the Galleon Award in two distinct and separate categories. The first time he won the award was many years ago for his teaching of Spanish and English as a second language, and this time he will receive the Galleon Award as a professor of business administration and international business. Professor Ali currently teaches sales, marketing, international business, international marketing, and real estate. He has earned advanced degrees from the University of Wyoming and Thunderbird, the American Graduate School of International Management. He is from the state of Wyoming. Is Tony Ali here somewhere? There he is. R. Ali, Professor of Marketing, recipient of the Galleon Award, the highest honor bestowed for excellence in teaching by the Illinois Central College Board of Trustees, presented May 23, 1993.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Becky. It is indeed an honor to have been selected as the 1993 recipient of the Galleon Award, and to join my friend, Dr. Jim Miller, as the only repeat winners, and to become the first professor in the history of Illinois Central College to receive the award in two separate and distinct areas. I suggest to each of you, as one of my former teachers and parents suggested to me, that you are smarter than you think. This concept has served as a confidence builder and motto throughout my career. As you search for methods of positioning yourself with career choices, you are very much aware that we live in a country of transition. Our global environment is undergoing breathtaking changes. Never before in American history have U.S. businesses been so deeply involved and affected by international trade. The trends are affecting U.S. businesses, small or large, domestic and international. You will agree that we live in an international society. It is vital that we adapt the concept of global interdependence because every American business company is international, at least to the extent that its business performance is conditioned in part by events that occur abroad. The business of American business is international business because the world is rapidly becoming a one-world economic marketplace. As you graduate, you will be on your way to becoming a world global citizen. I suggest that you become familiar with global literacy. It means being able to see the world in new ways as you observe the fever through democracy throughout the globe. As future leaders in the 21st century, you must be objective in assessing opportunities, evaluating potential, and responding to programmed and unprogrammed decisions as we did today. It is important that you condition yourselves to be tolerant in understanding cultural differences and accepting and working with others whose behavior may be different from yours. You do not have to accept this behavior as your own, but you must allow others to be different but equal. I recommend the following principles of vision. Be patient. You can do anything you want if you stick to it long enough. Education is not instant. Commit yourself to a life learning process ongoing. Be purposeful. Have a set of goals and follow that goal. Plan and have alternative plans as we did today. Believe deeply that what you have to offer is something very special and that nobody else but you can offer that. Be true to yourself. Don't worry if you make a mistake. The only people who never fail are those who never try. But neither do they ever succeed. Believe in yourself. Be determined. Focus on something rather than being confused by everything. Face the challenge and constantly strive to cultivate the confidence to know what you can and should accomplish. Be persistent. There are no shortcuts on the way to realizing your dream. Give all that you have to all that you do. Be on guard. Your integrity is important and it will be challenged. Everything in life is not fair or good. Practice the golden rule. Keep things in perspective. Always look for ways to leave someone feeling better about who they are. Continue to strive to make a difference. So always remember that you are smarter than you think. And always practice positive self-talk. I can do it. I like myself. I'm the best I have to offer. I have and will continue to make a difference. The world still has not learned to live with itself. The search for the answers and solutions may come from you, the ICC graduating class of 1993. Take charge, because the purpose of education is to enrich your life and to be change agents in society. Que sera, sera. The future is not ours to see. Whatever will be because of what you will do and the changes and difference that you will make as you see things as they might be instead of how they are or used to be. As you step into your future with confidence, be proud to be you. Be proud to be you. Be proud to be you. I am proud of this moment. I'd like for my family to stand. May happy memories be yours today, success be yours in your tomorrows, and happiness be yours always. Congratulations to you and yours. Thank you.
Also today, I have the honor of announcing the recipient of our Teaching Excellence Award winner. This woman has taught German at ICC since 1970. She graduated from Bradley University and did her graduate work at ISU. She has been involved at ICC's College for Kids for about 5 years. I'd like to introduce to you Annie Prohaska. For Annie says, German Language Program, English Department, recipient of the Teaching Excellence Award, the highest honor bestowed for part-time faculty by the Illinois Central College Board of Trustees, presented May 23, 1993.
I am very honored to receive this award in a sense of gratitude for myself and my colleagues in the Foreign Language Department. I am grateful to my students for nominating me and to the selection committee for choosing me. I also want to thank ICC for giving me the opportunity to do what I like to do best, that is teaching. Since I'm going to retire by the end of this summer, I not only bid farewell to the class of 93, but to all of ICC. Goodbye, au revoir, adios, and auf Wiedersehen.
This college was extremely honored this year to have had a student selected the first team on the Phi Theta Kappa Academic All-American team. That student was Cindy Bird. Cindy Bird is receiving this recognition award after being selected to this prestigious junior college team as the first student ever in the history of this school and the second student in the state to have received that award. In addition to serving as the Phi Theta Kappa Alumni Chapter Advisor, Cindy is the Executive Secretary in our Business Affairs Department and participates in Delta Society, Pets with Partners, and makes a number of nursing home visits. Cindy is an excellent example of many of our non-traditional students who work full-time and participate in numerous community and campus activities while pursuing their academic goals. This college is very, very proud of Cindy Burke. Would you please step forward? Reads Cynthia L. Bird, selected to the prestigious 1993 Phi Theta Kappa Academic All-America First Team, presented with pride by the Illinois Central College Board of Trustees, May 13, 1993.
Thank you. It was an extreme honor to be selected to the USA Today Academic All-America Team for Community and Junior Colleges. And I'm very proud to have the opportunity to represent all of you, the students of Illinois Central College and of community colleges nationwide. It was a very moving and rewarding experience to meet my fellow First Team members, to hear their stories, and to see how they are truly exemplary of what community colleges are all about, providing opportunity to students of all ages and all walks of life. I'm also proud that my award brought well-deserved recognition to Illinois Central College and to Phi Theta Kappa, two institutions that have richly rewarded my life in many ways and provided me with many opportunities for growth and learning. We're very fortunate to have in ICC a caring and dedicated staff, faculty, administrators, and a conscientious board of trustees who work together to provide high quality education along with community commitment. For it is this sense of community that sets ICC and all community colleges apart, not just in name, but in purpose and in direction. It's been written that among the most vital things an education must try to produce is some skill to perform useful service and some urge to fit that service into the well-being of the community. Service is one of the hallmarks of Phi Theta Kappa as well. Service to the Honor Society, to the college, and to the community. And we should utilize our educations to make this same commitment to service and to community. And just as learning is lifelong, so must this commitment be lifelong. But we get involved in our day-to-day business of living, and we lose sight of this sometimes. I know I have, and that's when you reach down inside of yourself and you do some soul searching. You evaluate success in different ways. Some might look at my award and say that I have achieved success, but success is not a point at which we arrive in our lives. It's the spirit with which we undertake and continue our journey through life. When I was 9 years old, I was totally paralyzed by a disease called Guillain-Barré syndrome, and I nearly died. But with extensive physical therapy and loving care of family and friends, I recovered. And I don't tell this story to gather sympathy from you. I tell it to emphasize the importance of inner strength and resolve. When you're confronted with a life and death situation at any age, it makes everything you do after that take on a different perspective. It grows. Your perspective grows. You live life with deeper meaning and feelings, with greater passion and compassion. And that's why I'm the person I am. But it doesn't have to take similar circumstances in your life for you to live deeper and say, take service to others more seriously. It's simply the difference between sitting back and being content or getting up and doing something about it and taking action. I can't express my feelings any better than did George Bernard Shaw when he said, "I am of the opinion that my life belongs to the whole community, and as long as I live it, it is my privilege to do for it whatever I can. I want to be thoroughly used up when I die. For the harder I work, the more I live. I rejoice in life for its own sake. Life is no brief candle. It's a sort of splendid torch which I've got to hold up for the moment and make it burn as brightly as possible before handing it on to future generations. So graduates, carry your torches proudly, knowing that the education you have received from Illinois Central College will help them to burn brightly in service and commitment to community. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Cindy. Phi Theta Kappa has always been the true hallmark of scholarship in the community college. We're fortunate this afternoon to have as our student speaker Michael Down. Michael has been president this past year of Phi Theta Kappa and again is our community college honorary society. They stress scholarship, leadership, and service to the college and to the community. One of the most rewarding projects that Phi Theta Kappa is involved with is the adoption of Garfield School, where they work with children from the south side of Peoria, both on their campus and on ours. Michael represents the typical Illinois Central College returning adult, where she's the mother of three children and a grandmother of two children. She attends college part-time and has completed her Associate in Arts and Sciences degree in 4 years. She'll go on to St. Francis School of Nursing to earn her bachelor's degree. Illinois Central College is very proud to have as our student speaker this afternoon, Michael Downs.
Four years ago, I came to a point in my life where decisions had to be made. And in making those decisions, there was risk. According to the dictionary, risk means to expose a chance of loss, harm, or danger. But life is a risk. Harold Macmillan once stated, "To be alive at all involves some risk." One of those decisions that I needed to make was whether to return to school after a 30-year lapse. Many questions entered my mind. Could I do it? What would it be like to be in a classroom again? If I fall down, I can get back up and go again. To fall doesn't make me a failure. What would make me a failure is to not get up and try again. By moving forward and onward, we gain valuable lessons to help us meet and overcome the risks that we most assuredly will encounter. Thank you, instructors, counselors, dear friends that I've made these 4 years here. I go forward with honor and hope that I can return that honor back to ICC by being successful in my chosen field of nursing. Thank you again. I'll not forget any of you. And as I graduate, I'll always stand behind this college that made my new life possible. I leave you with a quote from Theodore Roosevelt. "It is impossible to win the great prizes of life without running risks."
I hope the speech instructor is here. Proud, or she would have been proud. Prior to my coming to Central Illinois 4 years ago, I spent some time in Colorado. So you can imagine this afternoon when I saw this person in a cowboy hat and cowboy boots come strolling into the assembly. Well, that person that was strolling in is our Pace Center Award today, Daniel Heilman. Dan graduated Illinois Central College with the class of 1989. He was also a member of Phi Theta Kappa, and he will receive from us today the Pace Center Award for successfully building on the academic education he started here. He was nominated for this award by his former teacher, mathematics professor, Art Moser. In nominating him, Professor Moser said, "Dan was the ideal student. He ate up ideas like a starving man. You could see the lights go on as comprehension took place. I see Dan as a person salvaged from mediocrity by the opportunities he had at Illinois Central College. Dan is president and founder of Workhouses Incorporation, a nationwide firm which provides computer programs to assist home builders in estimating construction material needs. Dan wrote his first program for his company Carpenter's Dream as a class assignment while attending ICC. This company this year will have over $2 million in savings. He was an honor student at Illinois Central College, winning the Faculty Forum Scholarship. After earning his Associate in Arts and Sciences degree, Dan attended the Colorado School of Mines. I'm very proud to introduce to you this afternoon our Pace Center Award winner this year, Dan Heilman."
Thank you, Dr. Thomas. Did I do all that? First, I'd like to thank my wife, Peggy, for supporting me through school, and my daughter and sons, one of which is here today, Bo Heilman, who we hope to graduate this next year, fingers crossed. And also, I'd like to thank my mom and dad, and they're down there, and hi, Mom. Always wanted to see you. Hi, Mom. ICC, what a great school. I was just also honored with inclusion to Who's Who of Global Business Leaders. But the honor I received today here means much more. Thanks to people like Art Moser. I bugged him all the time. I mean, I was in his office. Is this formula work? Is this right? And yeah, I wasn't even in his class anymore. And he would still take me in and work with me. And a bunch of the instructors, like Roger Dunn, and Rita Fishback, and Stan Rose, and John Vanderborn, Bill Wesley, and many more. These people also honored me with the Forum Faculty Scholarship Award. And these people were with the schools.
This is a very proud day for colleges across the country, graduation day, and especially proud for us this afternoon. There are seven people that spend a lot of time out here doing a lot for this college, our Board of Trustees. I'd like to introduce the trustees to you at this time. First of all, from Pekin, Robert Eric. From Peoria, Mary Helen. Also from Peoria, Ken Heinrichs. From far away El Paso, William Kitchell. From Tri-Holy, Jerry Wright. Our student member, Becky Wagner. Lois Owens is not here today, and I'm the chairperson of our board this year, and would like to make a few remarks. Douglas Stewart, Germantown Hills.
Thank you, Dr. Thomas. To the graduates, faculty, relatives and friends of the graduates today. Graduation seems to not only have this sense of happiness and joy, but to a certain extent, a sense of finality. People are leaving an institution to go about pursuing new careers, new goals in their life. But in the case of Illinois Central College, those graduates who will be staying in the area or who will be coming back to the area, it really isn't appropriate for us to say goodbye to you. In fact, it's probably more appropriate to say see you around or see you again, because you will be back to see us again. Learning, as has already been stated, is a lifelong process. And community colleges, such as ICC, are better equipped to handle this lifelong learning experience than any other educational institution. And as chairman of the board of ICC, I want to commit to you that we are going to go on meeting those educational needs of our community at large. And so who is it today that is graduating from ICC and that we probably will be seeing again in the future? There are 867 people who have qualified to receive diplomas or certificates today. And they are a great bunch of people. They have proven their academic excellence. 42 of today's graduates had a grade point average during their time at ICC of 3.8 or above. And in fact, 24 of those students had a perfect 4.0 or straight A average. If any of those students are with us today, I would appreciate it if they would stand so that we can recognize your academic excellence. Thank you. 27 of our graduates today will receive 2 degrees, and rather amazingly, we have 3 people today that are going to be taking 3 degrees home with them. We have members of our full-time staff that will be graduating, and in fact, there are 3 married couples here today who will be taking degrees home together. There has been much discussion already, and certainly will be more, about pride. Pride in our graduates. Your parents are proud of you, your spouses, your children, perhaps even your grandchildren, and certainly the friends that are here today. We're all proud of our 1993 graduating class. Many of you have overcome significant personal hardships in order to attain that degree. There is at least, however, one other thing that I would be proud of and that you should be proud of today, and that is this institution, Illinois Central College. Over the past 26 years, ICC has become the college of choice. For instance, did you know that over 50% of the high school seniors who graduate from area high schools this year and will be going on to a college will be coming to ICC? Did you know that in the area of the so-called non-traditional student, those that will be defined as being people who are 25 years of age and older, those that decide to go back to college to get further education, that 4 times as many will come to ICC as will go to all other Central Illinois educational institutions combined? So why is it that ICC is the college of choice? Is it convenience, our location here, downtown, our satellite facilities? Is it the cost? Is it the breadth and flexibility of the curriculum? Certainly all of those items are important. But all of you as consumers know that just because something is convenient and just because something is less expensive, we will not continue to buy that product or service unless it adds value. And ICC does add value. For those of you who are going on to four-year colleges and universities, you might be interested in a bit of our research. On average, whatever Illinois university you go to, whether it's Northwestern, Bradley, ISU, the University of Illinois, whatever it may be, you will perform better than the native students that started out at those colleges and universities. You will also, on average, perform better than transfer students from all other community colleges in the state of Illinois. For those of you who are going into business and industry or already are in business and industry, you will find out that ICC is the major external training facility that your companies will continue to use. So, no doubt about it, ICC is the college of choice. We have our controversies, as evidenced by the past couple of weeks. But when it is all said and done, we have a faculty that is committed to educational excellence, who wants you all to be able to excel. We have an administration, a staff, and a board committed to the highest academic standards while meeting the needs of our entire community within the resources made available to us. So together, faculty, board, administration, we are proud of this institution, and we are therefore proud of the people that we call our graduates. So Dr. Thomas, without further rhetoric or comment, let's proceed with that moment that everyone is waiting for.
Would the faculty, staff, and administration please rise? Chairperson Stewart, the faculty, staff, administration, and I would like to present the following candidates for degrees and certificates.
Dr. Thomas, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, I declare these candidates graduates of Illinois Central College, class of 1993. Today's first graduate is Sharon K. Lagore. Adina A. Voinovich. Michael Down. Jason Andrew Boyer. Daniel Scott Hunt. Matthew Brian Brush.
It's on.
Stacy Lynn Marchalonis. Kristen Francis Hawkberg. Virginia Irene Lickey. Jennifer Rebecca Runnels. Jean Ann Marie Howes. Stephanie L. Evans. Lori McMillian. Lisa L. Cook. Teresa Ann Falk. Christy Michelle Blank. Jonathan A. Ellison. Ryan Lee Hartzell. Douglas Henry Davis.
Yay!
Christine Lee Murphy. Sharon E. Burdett. Maddie Lee Russell Jr. Mary Ruth Lown. Stephen Gary Little.
Now would all of the graduates please stand? All graduates, it's time to take your tassel and toss it to the other side. You're now graduated. I'd like to thank all of you very much for being students at Illinois Central College. All of us are very proud of what you have done today. We're also proud that you were very versatile and all of you made it from one place to the other. And that shows that you're ready to graduate. We will now have our final prayer and then we will recess in a normal manner even though our music has been rained out. So we will have a prayer.
And now may God go with you where you go, into the shop and the marketplace, into the mall and the academy, into the church and the home, and into foreign lands. Know that God goes with you from this place, that you are not alone. God sustains and guides forever and ever and ever. Amen.